Hi.
Hi. What a nice surprise. Merry Christmas.
Merry almost Christmas.
Happy New Year.
Yes, almost.
How you guys doing? You good?
Yeah, we're great. Actually, we're better than okay. Danny just passed his 60-day biopsy.
Fantastic. That's the best news I've got since Robin came home.
So, you chose Robin?
Yes, I did. You don't seem surprised.
Actually, I am not.
Well, you told me deep down I knew which woman I had to choose. And you were right. I came home to Robin after breaking Sabrina's heart. I was so scared to make a decision, so paralyzed not to hurt Sabrina, that I ended up hurting both Sabrina and Robin.
I am sure it was difficult for her.
Yeah, it was. But saying goodbye to Sabrina was about as painful as I thought it was going to be. But coming home to Robin was the right decision, and it was like a dream.
A dream come true.
Mm-hmm. You know how you miss all the small things, like Robin used to chew her pen when she'd be reading the paper before she'd stir her jam up, before she put on her toast. I missed all that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
And it's so nice to have it back.
I'm sure I used to dream about Jason coming back, walking through that door, but I don't do that anymore. You got your miracle. There's only one to go around. And I can't think like that anymore.
Why? Because of Silas?
You were right when you encouraged me a few months ago to go out with Silas.
That's good. So things are going good.
It's good.
What do you mean it's good? How good? Come on, I'm being nosy. How good? Yeah!
Okay, yes, you're being a little bit nosy, but I know it's coming from a good place, so...
Look, we've both been through a terrible slump. The worst loss, the worst pain, I understand how hard it is to move on, so I just want to be a friend to you and listen the way you were to me.
Okay, I might be oversharing a little bit, but since you asked...
Okay.
Silas and I, we haven't actually closed the deal yet.
Really?
Yeah.
Is there a reason for that? What's holding you back? I know you didn't come over to be interrogated, but I mean...
Oh, stop. No worries. Okay. There's no particular reason why Silas and I haven't taken it to the next level. I mean, I know we both kind of want to. It's just timing hasn't really been on our side. Yeah, I was dealing with Danny, and Silas obviously has his patients, and then I find out that Julian Jerome is my father. It's just...
So really? It's just because...
This hasn't happened.
There's no time on your side?
Right.
Really?
And, well... His ex, Ava Jerome... Mm. She keeps warning me that Silas has some secret. I think Ava was jealous, so she badmouthed Silas.
You don't think there's anything to it?
Why would I? Every word out of her mouth is a lie.
All right, I have to say this. I thought so too, but...
But what?
Ava was telling me the truth when she told me that Robin was alive. Ava took it upon herself to come here and tell me that Carlos saw Robin in the lab. I mean, I even went to the lab to go look for myself. I was convinced that Ava was lying, but it turns out that she wasn't.
It's different. Why would Ava lie to you? There's nothing in it for her.
Okay, but what does she get by lying to you about Silas?
She's jealous, and she wants her ex back, and she's a compulsive liar, and that's what she does.
Okay. Look, I don't want to question your motives. I'm just trying to make sure you know my side.
That's actually very nice. And you care.
Of course I care. You were great to me. I just want to return the favor, and I want to see you happy.
I am. I should probably get going. If I can tear Danny away from you, you're so good with him.
Well, I spent a lot of my time this last crazy year thinking I was going to have another kid. And when Britt told me that it wasn't happening, I was, the baby wasn't mine. I was pretty upset because I was excited about it.
Well, this isn't an easy solution. You have your wife back. Why don't you ask Robin?